The new capabilities we are introducing will enhance your financial processes with the power of agents. They will automate repetitive tasks and streamline complex, error-prone financial analysis. Let's see how. As a financial analyst, one of my common tasks is analyzing variances between revenue forecasts and actual revenue. This can be really time-consuming, but the variance analysis agent automates the process. It works in the background and sends me a Teams notification with the summarized results of its build revenue analysis. Couple of variances. That's interesting. Let's learn more. I open a notification, and it takes me to the report in Excel. The agent gives me a summary of the key variances. It highlights important differences in the financial results, either favorable or unfavorable, and gives accurate financial commentary explaining the root cause. Looks like we've actually beaten expectations in the UK and Canada, driven by our new line of smart vending machines. Oof, that's a relief. I do have some questions about why this may be, though. I could spend lots of time poring through financial data myself to understand some of the driving factors, but again, time-consuming. So instead, I ask the agent to look at macroeconomic factors and give me its assessment. It looks at both internal and external content, such as sales metrics, order data, and news reports. This helps me understand the factors that may have contributed to this positive development. Looks like there are some interesting market trends driving growth more than was expected. Now, this is great from a macroeconomic point of view, but let's tailor this a little bit more by opening the agent details. Within the details, I can see a history of previous runs and recent insights from quarter to quarter. This gives me an overall understanding of the macro trends for the business. This is also where I can modify and enhance the agent. I can add additional data sources to further inform the agent's analysis. Here, I want to understand the impact our marketing campaigns may have had on our overperformance. So I add our marketing reports for the quarter, which include various promotions, social media campaigns, and other KPIs. From now on, the variance analysis agent will look at both macroeconomic trends and the potential effects of our own marketing efforts. I'm not a marketer, but I'm going to share this with the marketing team so that they know how and where to optimize their spend going forward. Now, back to finance for a second. Another thing teams often struggle with is the reconciliation of data across multiple systems and in multiple formats. So I navigate to my financial reconciliation agents to see how well they're functioning. I can see from this that they've done a great job at catching problems with unreconciled data and correcting them. I'll drill into an individual agent to see how it's performing, and if necessary, make modifications. For example, I can check this agent to ensure billed revenue is correctly reflected between all legal entities. This has been a huge time saver for me and for my team. 24 hours worth over the last month, in fact. The whole department is working faster, more accurately, and with higher quality than ever before. To learn more about these and other new features being released, check out our 2025 Wave 1 release notes.